Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. Whatever time it is for you in your geographical location, you're welcome to the Sure Word for today's audio daily devotion. This is the Sure Word for today, the abundance of the free favor of the Lord. Dear Lord, I am alone in the room. It's just me and you. I feel so lost because I don't know what to do. Now, what if I choose the wrong thing to do? I'm so afraid of disappointing you. So I need to talk to you, Lord, and ask you for your guidance, especially today when my life is so cloudy. Guide me until I'm sure. I open up my heart to you, Lord. Amen. Today is Saturday, the 5th of December, 2020. The Sure Word title for this week is Be Optimistic, Part 7 of 7, the last part of this series, written by Jefferson Otombara Imgbi. The Sure Word for today's quotation for this week is, God have made me rejoice. All scriptural quotations, unless otherwise indicated, are taken from the King James Version of the Holy Bible. The Bible verse for this week is taken from the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 16. Here is the Bible quotation. Rejoice evermore. End of Bible reading. The real difference between an optimist and a pessimist isn't in their level of happiness or in how they perceive a situation, but in how they cope. Life is tough and rough. Things are not easy fetch. As such, you have no option but to be optimistic. Being optimistic is no longer a choice. It is compulsory. Being optimistic allows you to handle stressful situations better, which reduces the harmful health effects of stress on your body. Science shows that those with an optimistic outlook have better cardiovascular health and a stronger immune system, and a higher income and have more successful relationships. I believe you want all these benefits in your life. The mindset of the optimist enables them to view the world, other people and events in the most favorable, positive light possible. Some people describe this as the half-glass full mentality. At the moment, we are dealing with a global pandemic. We hear stories, propagandas, conspiracies, and negative news that creates fear. You need to rise above all the negativity and make the best of the coronavirus. Yes, you heard me. The fact you are alive is a reason to be grateful to God. Continue to pray for the healing of the infected. Positive thinking doesn't mean that you ignore life's stressors. You just approach hardship more productively. Optimism bias, or the optimistic bias, is a cognitive bias that causes someone to believe that they are less likely to experience a negative event. It is also known as unrealistic optimism or comparative optimism. This bias leads one to believe that they are less likely to suffer from misfortune and most likely to attain success than reality will suggest. Why do most Christians pretend they are okay when they are struggling, even when help is there? They have religious bias, and they are being destroyed because of lack of knowledge. You need to renew your mind with the Word of God if you want to be optimistic. You cannot solve a problem with the same mind that created it. Your mind is a powerful thing. When you fill it with positive thoughts, your life will start to change. The measure of success is happiness and peace of mind. Train your mind to see the good in every situation. This is the end of the last part of the Sure Word audio devotion series titled, Be Optimistic. Christianity is called the Great Confession, but most Christians who are defeated in life are defeated because they believe and confess the wrong things, and these words hold them in bondage. Faith-filled words will put you over. Fear-filled words will defeat you. Words are the most powerful thing in the universe. Spoken words program your spirit either to success or defeat. Here is your faith-filled word for this week. Make the following word confession after me. I declare God's incredible blessings over my life. I declare God's incredible blessings over my life. I will see an explosion of God's goodness, a sudden widespread increase. I will see an explosion of God's goodness, a sudden widespread increase. I will experience the surpassing greatness of God's favor. I will experience the surpassing greatness of God's favor. It will elevate me to a level higher than I ever dreamed of. It will elevate me to a level higher than I ever dreamed of. Explosion blessings are coming my way. Explosion blessings are coming my way. I am a masterpiece. I am handpicked by God. I am loved. I am a masterpiece. I am handpicked by God. I am loved. I am a person of extreme value and significance. Amen. I am a person of extreme value and significance. Amen. We want to say thank you to everybody who follows us across our various channels. If you haven't yet, please do so. You will find our social media links for Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and our daily devotion subscription in the description of this audio and video recording. Click, subscribe, follow, like, share, speak about it, and tweet it. We appreciate your loving kindness of spreading this gospel to the four corners of the earth. Thank you.